Dear students, in this video we discuss Thomas Kitsch and his play The Spanish Tragedy or Hieronymo is Mad Again. Thomas Kitsch seems to be a leading playwright of the Elizabethan period. He was born in 1558, some 6 years before the birth of Shakespeare and Christopher Marlowe. Marlowe and Shakespeare were born in 1564. Thomas Kitsch studied at the Merchant Taylors' School. And at the school, Edmund Spenser and Thomas Lodge were his schoolmates. And there is no evidence to prove that Kitsch attended any of the universities. But his name has been included in the group of the university wits, identified by George Saintsbury. It was George Saintsbury, a 19th century writer, who called a group of poets, playwrights and pamphleteers as university wits. And the prominent among them were Christopher Marlowe, Robert Greene and Thomas Nash from Cambridge University, John Lilly, Thomas Lodge and George Peely from Oxford. Even though Kitsch didn't study in any of the university, his name was also included in the group of the university wits due to certain characteristics shared equally among the people. And they stood for secularism. And these all playwrights used high-sounding dialogues and blank words. Most often they took their themes from the great classics and epics, discussed about the stories of great heroes. And comedy never peeped in their writing, except in John Lilly. As far as Thomas Kitsch is concerned, he is mainly known for his play The Spanish Tragedy. And during the time of Thomas Kitsch, the play was considered anonymous. It was in 1773, a dramatic critic named Thomas Hawkins, identified that the play was attributed to Thomas Kitsch in a book written by Heywood entitled Apology for Actors. In a book entitled Apology for Actors by Thomas Heywood, there has been a reference that the Spanish Tragedy was written by Thomas Kitsch. And it was identified by Thomas Hawkins in 1773. And up to the time, the play was considered anonymous. And it was the identification made by Thomas Hawkins that made the play produced by Thomas Kitsch. And there are again a few works attributed to Thomas Kitsch. It is believed that Kitsch wrote Your Hamlet. That became source material for Shakespeare's Hamlet. Your is a Latin word which refers to old or earliest. And Kitsch also produced a Senecan tragedy called Cornelia. And it was actually a translation from a French writer, Robert Garnier. And he also produced the King Lear, Arden of Feversham. And it is also believed that Kitsch produced the play Edward III. And there was also a prose pamphlet written by Kitsch named The Murder of John Brewin. And it was actually a report on a murder in a family that took place in the house of a goldsmith. The goldsmith was murdered by his wife. And Keith was very close with Christopher Marlowe. Both shared a single room for some time in London. And during the time, Marlowe was arrested for suspicion of spreading heresy. And Kidd escaped from there. And Marlowe was executed also. He was murdered. And Kidd died at the age of 35. In the next year, after the death of Christopher Marlowe, Marlowe was dead in 1593 and Kidd became dead in 1594. And Spanish tragedy has been the most popular of his plays. And it is considered as a Senecan tragedy of blood, a revenge tragedy. And it imitates the Senecan tragedy entitled Thyestes. And in this revenge tragedy, we come to find revenge played on, revenge taking place on the theatre, on the stage itself. And there has been also a character called Revenge. The ghost of revenge is also found in the play. And the play has got four acts. In the first act of the play, an introduction to the play has been given. And there are two ghosts introduced in the beginning of the play. And one ghost is that of the Spanish courtier named Don Andrea. Don Andrea comes to the stage along with another ghost called Revenge. Don Andrea was formerly a Spanish courtier and he was killed in the battle against Portugal by the Portuguese prince named Balthasar. And when he was killed in the battle, his soul reached Hades, hell, and waited at the gates for 3 days. And when he was given a burial, when Don Andrea was given a burial by Horatio, the son of Hieronymo, his soul entered the hell and reached the castle of Pluto. And Pluto's wife Proserpine wanted him to return to the earth to see the revenge taken on his death. So he was asked to go to the earth to witness the revenge on his murder, Balthasar being killed by Bellimperia. Formerly, Don Andrea was in love with Bellimperia. And during the battle, when he was killed by Balthasar, Horatio tried to save him. And in a single combat with Balthasar, he captured Balthasar. And it was Horatio who gave the burial to Don Andrea. And at the time of the burial, he took a scarf from the dead body. And it was actually the scarf given by Bellimperia at the time of his departure. In the opening act of the play, the ghost Don Andrea introduces his story. And so the circumstances that led him to come to see the revenge taken on his death. Proserpine sent Revenge, another ghost, to accompany Don Andrea's ghost. And Don Andrea, in the opening scene of the play, tells his story. And Revenge is also found describing his story, how he was asked to accompany Don Andrea. And Don Andrea and Revenge both remain in the stage invited to see the revenge taking place. And they perform as chorus in the play. And in the second act scene of the play, in the first act, in the second scene, we come to find the Spanish Duke, Duke Castilli, the father of Belimbiria and Lorenzo, on the stage. Hieronimo and a general are also there. And the general tells Duke Castilli about the battle, how they won the Portuguese people. Portugal was conquered by Spain. And they took away with them the Portuguese prince, Balthasar. And a little later, the victorious soldiers, including Lorenzo, Horatio, are found taking Balthasar with them. And both claim that they have conquered Balthasar. And the Duke Castilli, so comedy means both Horatio and his son Lorenzo for capturing Balthasar. And Lorenzo is asked to keep Balthasar with him and to take his armor, arms, and Horatio is offered a ransom for capturing Balthasar, and both become satisfied with the rewards offered to them. And Balthasar is taken by Lorenzo in the castle, even though he was put under captivity. So he was permitted to move about in the castle with Lorenzo, and he finds Belimbiria and becomes attracted to him. And in the meantime, Horatio, the son of Hieronimo, falls in love with Belimbiria. Belimbiria falls in love with Horatio with the intention of taking revenge on the murder of her first love, Don Andrea. Her lover Don Andrea was killed by Balthasar, and the story was told to her by Horatio. Horatio also shows her the scarf he had taken from the dead body of Don Andrea and hands it over to Belimbiria. Actually, it was the scarf given by Belimbiria at the time of Don Andrea's departure for the battle. And Don Andrea's death so makes her sorrowful, but she takes the decision to take revenge on the death of her lover Don Andrea. And in fact, she falls in love with Horatio with the intention of taking revenge on the death of her lover. And it is at the same time, Balthasar also feels attracted to Belimbiria. And in the next scene, we come to find an ambassador from the Portuguese side coming to the Spanish court to make negotiations. And he proposes the idea of making a marriage between Balthasar and Belimbiria to patch up the issues connected with the war. And the decision is welcomed by Lorenzo and the others. And Lorenzo comes to understand that Belimbiria has been in secret love with Horatio. So he engages Belimbiria's servant, Pendringano, to have an eye on Belimbiria to identify if there is any secret love affair between Belimbiria and Horatio. And Pendringano intimates Lorenzo that Belimbiria and Horatio are in love. And he also intimates Lawrence that they are having a secret rendezvous, a secret meeting in a bower. Lawrence and Balthasar go to the bower and kills Horatio, hanging him from an arbor and stabbing him. And Bellimbiria is taken into house arrest, and she was put in the house under arrest. And she writes a letter about the death of Horatio to Hieronymo, using her own blood. And the death of Horatio becomes known to Hieronymo. Hieronymo and his wife find the dead body of Horatio, and they vow revenge on the death. And it is at the same time Pedringano is asked by Lorenzo to kill Balthasar's servant, Cerberine. So he offered, Lorenzo offered Pedringano rewards and asked him to keep the murder of Horatio a secret. In fact, to keep the murder of Horatio as a secret, Pedringano is asked to kill Balthasar's servant Cerberine. And if Pedringano will be arrested, he will be released by Lorenzo. And expecting a reward from Lorenzo and believing in the words of Lorenzo, Pedringano kills Cerberine, shooting him, and he was arrested by the police and sent to the gallows. And before his death, he writes a letter to Lorenzo, but it accidentally comes into the hands of Hieronymo. The letter from Bellimbiria, formerly received by Hieronymo, had given him the idea that his son was killed by Lorenzo and Balthasar. But he had no solid evidence. And the letter written by Pedringano to Lorenzo also tells about the murder of Horatio committed by Lorenzo and Balthasar. Makes him believe that his son was killed by Balthasar and Lorenzo. And when the marriage preparations are made, Hieronymo is asked to stage a play as part of the celebrations. And Hieronymo in the beginning wants to have justice on the death of his son. But he feigns support to Lorenzo and Balthasar. So he keeps the revenge in his mind and plans for the murder, for the revenge, with support from Bellimbiria. And he stages a play in front of the Duke and the Spanish king and the others. Before the marriage, a play was performed in front of them, and it was a play written by Hieronymo. And the play was entitled Soliman and Perseda. In the story of Soliman and Perseda, Perseda was loved by a knight, and Soliman the king actually wanted to win Perseda, and he wanted his Basha to kill the knight. The Basha kills the knight, and Perseda is revengeful, and she kills Soliman, and she commits suicide. In the play, The role of Soliman is played by Balthasar. And the role of the knight is played by the knight who is in love with Belimbiria. The knight who is in love with Perseida is played by Lorenzo. So in the play, inside the play, Balthasar plays the role of Soliman, and Belimbiria plays the role of Perseida. And the role of the knight is played by Lorenzo. And Hieronymo plays the role of the Basha. Soliman wanted the Basha to kill the knights. And Basha, the role played by Hieronymo, kills the knights. Lorenzo is killed by Hieronymo. And Belimbiria becomes offended, Perseida becomes offended, and she kills Soliman, and after all she commits suicide. And when the play is performed before the people, real daggers were issued to them instead of fake daggers. And the killings were done on the stage. And when the play becomes ended, the people come to understand the murders were real. And Hieronymo addresses the people and tells them the reason why he was made to stage the play and to arrange the killings. So he actually wanted to take revenge on the death of his son Horatio. And after all, he bites off his tongue and spits it out, stabs the Duke and kills himself. And the revenge being completed, and the ghosts who are there to watch the revenge become happy, and they return to the Hades. And this is the content of the play. And there are many murders taking place on the stage. And the play has been presented as a Senecan tragedy. The title Hieronymo is Mad Again is used by T.S. Eliot in his poem The Wastelands. In the last part of The Wastelands, he refers to the term Hieronymo is Mad Again. It appears in line number 431. There are 433 lines in The Wastelands. And in line number 431, so we come to find the term Hieronymo is Mad Again. And the line is, why then, illy fit you, Hieronymo is Mad Again. And the next line is, Detta Daidvam Damyada. And the last line is Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. And the theme appears in the last episode of The Wastelands, entitled What the Thunder Says. I told you, so the play was written by Thomas Keats. Between the years 1582 to 1592, and the exact year of the play is not clearly known. You know, there are no references to the Spanish Armada that took place in 1588. So we come to conclude that the play was written before 1588, most probably in 1587. And there are many Latin terms used in the play, and they are called the marginalia. So in Christopher Marlowe and in the University of Weeds, we come to find many Latin terms also used, which are called the marginalia. And in the Spanish tragedy also, we come to find the marginalia. There are a few terms used by one among the popular Latin term used by Thomas Kidd in the play is vindicta mihi. It means revenge is due to me. And there are also many details about the play, and this is only a briefing of the play, and the details can be found in the notes given to you. Thank you.